Newcastle's 102.9 Triple M's Tenure and Steve. It's 7:43. Bit of smoke haze hanging around. It should stick around till this afternoon. Tops at 28 on the coast, 29 for Maitland and the Valley.
In season 2020, we find ourselves in a new position. The man to take us forward is new head coach, Adam O'Brien.
Where's your first stop for any new Knights coach in Newcastle?
Triple M, and we have...
Tenure, Steve.
We all kind of stand, yeah. And okay. This is kind of cruisy, so you just kind of have to be, bang on the mic there, if that's cool.
I don't think there's anyone more passionate than the Knights fans, so... look, I understand. I clearly understand the nature of the business. As I said to the guys a little bit earlier, if you're going to accept the pats on the back, you need to accept the kicks up the backside.
Behind these four walls, the squad will be challenged. But for these two players, they're already looking within.
Rachel's looking after us, always. A little bit. I'm ready.
Underway. I have to be under 50.
I have to be under 54 conditional. So
they got.
So just shave a couple off, eh? All over. We'll just stay.
We might just have to starve ourselves.
I was going to say 5 days.
I'm not leaving a sauna. I might just live in it. Camp in it.
Looking lazy.
Does sauna have like benefits for that?
For the skinnies?
No, in fact, you come out. You come out. The higher fold.
Yeah, because your skin's loose, yeah.
Yeah.
What must be?
I was.
Oh no!
Sit on the chair.
I'm nervous, bud.
Sit on the chair.
Sit on the chair.
Are you sure?
Yeah, shuffle forward, leave out straight behind the
room. I reckon this is going to be, if you were 49, I reckon I'll be at 51.
Stand up.
Yeah. Pretty good. 51, 53.
Chin and face me. So they've all got targets that they left off the end of season with. Yeah. So they've got to hit those targets before they start next week.
Talk to me.
51.
Under text, it's all about it.
Under my target. 54, I'm pretty sure he said. And under text, easy, mate. Money.
Adam, it's good to have you guys in town. When I say guys, you and your wife.
Yep.
I know Newcastle is going to make you guys feel very, very welcome.
Absolutely.
Particularly if we get some wins. So yes. Good luck.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
And no pressure.
Yes, none whatsoever.
It's Daniel and Steve. Triple M.
Thanks.
No worries.
Thanks,
mate.
Good, mate. That's
cheers.
Right.
Thank you.
Hope it was all right.
Yeah,
cheers.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Thanks. No worries.
Yeah, just have a chat, you know, every couple of weeks. And
I can tell by having 19 players there the other day of their own accord training tells me that, you know, they do want to make the region proud. You know, the end of the season last year wasn't nice for them either. It wasn't nice for the community or the Knights fans, and I feel a part of that too. But I think, I think the boys are fully aware. Their actions speak louder than their words, and I think Wednesday's a good example. It is only the start. That needs to continue, but I think that's what the community would want the most is, okay, well, you want to make us proud, we want to start seeing it, so.
So just driving in Newcastle now. Just heading to Robinson Property now to pick up the keys and sign a few papers to get it all official, and just can't wait to see the unit and get to know the area.
How's it going?
Good. Are you going to sign for the wallet?
Yes.
Yes, we are. No worries. Go on, I'm going to take a seat. Thank you.
Our newest addition is hooker Jaden Brayley. Having only just arrived in Newcastle, he not only brings a strong rugby league IQ, but a tremendous work ethic.
Now, who is the lucky one that gets to pay the second week's rent?
My friend.
You're good. Not for long.
I know it was a bit of a disappointing end to the season that was last year for the Knights, and for me, I've been lucky enough to not miss out on the final series in my last 3 years, so I don't want to start that now, and I'm just going to do everything that I can to make sure the Knights are playing finals football next year.
Returning from an ankle injury, A taste of first grade in 2019 is all the motivation teenage playmaker Phoenix Crossland needs to hit the ground running heading into the new year.
That's the one. You know, I've seen heaps of faces around, all the boys getting in and when they can, and you know, if they have a day off sort of without having to see too much family, they'll come in and do some training. I think Adam was a bit impressed with how many faces he's seen so far, so I think he knows everyone's ready to go. All in all, it's going to be a good 2020. Just a really good vibe at the moment.
Day one at the Knights, day one as a head coach.
The club had to be the right fit for me and I had to be the right fit for the club. I've been really patient. I think it took me 12 years to leave Craig at Melbourne and then obviously the 1 year at Roosters. So I've been really patient. There was 19 of them here on Wednesday when I drove through the gates. I was really, really happy. And then to see, I think there's about 21, 22. That's a large chunk of your squad here training.
If first impressions count, his new squad has made a good one.
For one of these players, Hymel Hunt, it marks the start of a new two-year deal. After just one season at the Knights, the centre's quickly gained admiration for both his teammates and the supporters.
With the apprenticeship that I've had, I've seen how teams behave, how they train, obviously with Melbourne, and being part of the last four grand finals, I think I can tell these guys out here, this is how we need to act every single day. And then the game, you know, should be the easy part if you get the other 6 days right. Just a country bloke that loves his footy and, you know, wants to enjoy everything that Newcastle has to offer. And of course, winning games goes a long way to that enjoyment.
Let's go!
This week marks Mitchell Pearce's 14th NRL pre-season. After a rollercoaster year which included the high of a New South Wales Origin victory and the low of having his leadership questioned, our halfback is focused as ever to make 2020 a winner.
How was the holiday?
Good, brother.
Good?
Had a good time.
Did you?
I think in any change there's always going to be a good rebound effect. Like the first, you know, we've got an eager group and everyone's super keen and obviously it was a lot going on. We're not talking about last year, but you're always going to get a good reaction and a real positive feel for the first week, and it's been a big tick.
Inside Knights HQ, Adam O'Brien holds his first official team meeting. Across the board, staff and players are all on the same page. The coach wastes little time getting acquainted with his troops. With introductions and niceties out of the way, it's time to rip in. Pre-season is officially underway. Blood, sweat, and head noise. This is where you develop character.
I try and be the fittest guy on the field and try and compete as hard as I can at training on the field all the time. So for me, that's a form of leadership. Pre-season is a good test of your character and your leadership. You're obviously pushing your body to the limit, so there's plenty of opportunities to get in there and help your teammate out. And that's definitely one form of leadership and a part of it that comes natural for myself, and I enjoy that. You know, I enjoy there trying to bust my backside for my teammates and try and win everything on the field.
Thank you.
Hey Knights fans, it's Connor Watson here, and I'm here to tell you about my story to the NRL.
All right, back again for another edition of the podcast. And
like early on, all I wanted to do was play NRL. And, you know, I used to tell my nan and just say, like, I'm going to play NRL for the Knights one day. And yeah.
At the start of every preseason, we go through a screening process with the physios and doctors just to check out your body and talk about medical history and how your muscles and joints are before going into the preseason. So yeah, it's just a part of the process.
See you, Josh.
See you, Connor.
They've come here pretty pumped up, and they're all happy and congratulating each other. It's been quite good, actually. Good vibes here this morning. I'm going back, nearly going back 20 odd years, you know, so they're very happy. I've never seen them this good for a long time.
In rugby league terms, 1, 6, 7 and 9, the spine is often a focal point. With a new hooker at the club, the next 13 weeks looms as an important time for the halfback and his rake to develop their combination.
I've marvelled at the way he plays at Cronulla for such a young guy. I thought he was a lot older than he was. He's mature, he's a professional, he's humble. That's him, the little dealings I've had with him, but you know, your first impressions, I've been really, really impressed with the way he trains, he's fit as. You can just see he's a team man, he wants to win and he's here for the right reasons, so I'm really looking forward to playing with him.
I don't think I could have picked a better club, to be honest. I got such a good opportunity with a great roster, a great town, a great lifestyle, and also a great coach as well in Adam O'Brien. So I'm just really keen to work hard and learn and hopefully take my game to the next level.
Yeah, I'm really, really excited about the coaching staff, and I've obviously been playing for a while and had a lot of different experiences, and we've got a pretty special one here, and you can see that from the start. We're a really good leader from the top. He's going to challenge us, he's going to challenge me, and we're all looking forward to it. It's going to be uncomfortable, but that's what creates winning.
And that's what the coach and his team are intent on building. Just when the boys thought they were finished for the week, a surprise hill session is called.
We use the hills again this year at King Edward. Early opportunity to see players throw a few curveballs at them and test them around the mentality side of what we do training-wise, and when they do get to games and it does get a bit tough, that they're ready for the unknown in terms of what potentially could come at them.
This pre-season, the players must live by the motto, expect the unexpected. Every team in the NRL has 30 spots to fill on their roster. Our newest addition is Inari Tawala. Having joined the team after 18 games for the Cowboys, he is player number 27 on the squad list. He drove 22 hours to be here for his first day of training. While Inari is eager to show his worth, he's not the only one with a point to prove. After all, no player is guaranteed their spot. It must be earned. The troops are on show in every session, and every effort counts. Mitch Barnett claimed the 2019 Danny Badiris Medal as Player of the Year. While you can't question his commitment on the field, quick thinking and a caring heart has exemplified his quality away from it too.
The youths are going to then drive down to the truck, and the other half of you guys will be down there unloading, putting it onto the truck, helping us sort it all out.
Tonight, dozens of trucks are still trying to contain spot fires.
As a Wingham boy, helping the people of the Mid-North Coast is something Mitch Barnett feels passionate about.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, thank you. Appreciate that. That's unreal.
We didn't give people too much time, but to come in this morning and see people have dropped things off overnight nearly brought a tear to my eye. So it's thank everyone that's played a part. And it's not just it might be me going up there and speaking here now, but I promise you it's a lot more. It's a whole community, and these people need everyone in the community to help, because at this stage they're devastated, and every little thought or helping hand counts.
Yeah, like I said, we'll just take the boys up there and just want to thank you. You're too kind, eh? I appreciate it. And everyone up there will appreciate it. It's a big effort, boys.
With the trip planned to send much needed supplies to Wingham, Taree, and Tuncurry, the entire night staff and office are on hand to pack the truck.
Water coming in, water coming in.
Excused from training for the day, Mitch Barnett and Josh King hit the road. That's the beauty of this game. It transcends sport.
Camped out last night, got up this morning, showed Kingy around Wingham, and here we are.
Our local policeman, Dave Abbott.
I know Dave Abbott very well.
Dave. Yeah. He is the biggest supporter of Newcastle Knights. He's just runs in his blood.
Oh. Yeah. It's a little bit emotional, but it's great to see everyone rallying together, that's for sure.
He used to put lovely love letters in my mailbox for my daughter.
That's the great thing about Australia. Everyone gets around everyone, so that's awesome. I don't even have Uber in here to get me there.
Can't really describe, like, you don't realise how affected the areas are until you come up here and really see it. You know, the drive to port for kilometres and kilometres, just burnt land, and we only scratch the surface of it really. Just to see some of the devastation and see how close it actually came to some houses. Like, you can't fathom how they were able to save some of the houses when the fire's literally at their doorstep.
It's really wonderful that they care about their community, and that's, I couldn't be prouder of them.
As the boys work in the dry heat, today is a reminder of what's really important.
Then we'll go together on our warm-up and we'll move forward from there, okay? Are we all wrapped and ready? Okay, sweet, let's go.
This is the fourth week in the pre-season block. Until this point, David Clemmer had been enjoying his break as a result of representing Australia in the Test side. But today, he's back on deck. With a player of his experience, Clemmer knows when training gets hard, you work harder. Clemmer's return could not have come at a better time.
Dave, just the enthusiasm he brings to the training group, he's just that excited to be here, and he's got a sense of the changes already, and he's definitely jumping full depth into what we're going to do.
To make a club, it takes more than just its players and coaches. It's a team of people working behind the scenes. Our club is a community, a family. So amongst the chaos, the players take time out of their day to prepare and serve lunch to the staff as a thank you for all their hard work.
From what I can gather, the staff made lunch for us. We serve the staff some lunch. Good initiative. We get together and get to know each other. So all the boys are pretty pumped for it, like you can see. So.
Here we go, first full week of summer, and sadly it is going to be a dry start. What is now the driest spring in Australia?
Four tackles, a quick transition. When they come back here, they've got 15 seconds off, then we do it again. Straight away, I want the transition. So if you finish with the ball, go straight into D. We're getting out and then getting back in.
Finished off, mate, pretty quick.
Yeah, so James is our GPS analyst, sports scientist, so James keeps an eye on both what we're doing on the field in terms of output physically, GPS numbers, whether that's game base and the intensity or the volumes we're running at within those games. And then we feed forward, or I feed forward back into the coaches to determine if we're hitting certain targets, discuss individuals that may need modification or may need more pushing to get them up to a certain standard.
So it's flying at the moment.
Even amongst the hard work and fatigue, there's nothing wrong with a bit of friendly competition. Meet Tex Hoy, a local product who has climbed up the grades.
This year, it's just gone quick, and it's getting faster, so got to prepare yourself the best you can, so you don't fall behind anyone else. I'm thinking it'll be a quicker day today as well, so get the legs going a bit quicker. So.
Tex is 20, and is working through his second NRL pre-season.
Well, last year I did my first pre-season, and obviously last year I was a little bit younger too and didn't know really what to expect, and it was, I don't know, come in and try to give my best.
Pre-season training. It's in the name. Training. And there's been plenty of that this week.
Started pretty fast and it sort of just got faster, but times are getting quicker for all the fitness things and stuff like that, and the skill level sort of getting back up to where we want it to be, and starting to do a bit more team 13 and 13 stuff, and yeah, a bit of more work, which has been good. Cool.
Hey, good footy, Brady.
Yo.
Fish it off, you fish it off.
Dog it in, dog it in.
David Clemmer has been back at training for just 1 week, and he's already hitting it off with our new recruit, Jaden Brayley.
Oh, you got gym last, eh?
Have you had something to eat?
Yeah, I had a bit of roast beef, mate. Got a sweet potato, a bit of pumpkin.
Oh, nice.
Bit of everything. It was nice. Probably the best one of the week.
How good is it, Clem?
Weather's good.
Where else would you rather be, mate?
Be sitting here with you, mate.
Hey, that's it, eh?
It's been 2 months since Brayley made the move from Canara, and the transition couldn't have gone any better.
4 weeks into training, loving every second of it so far. It's been pretty tough to start things off, but you know, it's such a beautiful spot to live, Merriweather and the whole of Newcastle, and close to the beach. And you know, it's, I guess in a lot of ways it's similar to Cronulla, but Edric Lee, I've known him from back at the Sharkies. He's made the transition a lot easier. And Mitch Pearce as well, he's from when he messaged me a couple of weeks ago, we caught up. He's been really good as well. So, you know, I'm loving the change. It's, you know, refreshing. And yeah, the club's been really good.
As one new recruit settles in, another exciting new prospect from up north has just been scouted.
This is a bit awkward. Over the last couple of weeks, I've spent a lot of time evaluating a lot of the players that are coming available at the end of the 2020 season. In all positions, I think it's really important to first look at our own squad and analyse where we can improve. In this game, obviously, there's certain players that you really like more than others, and fortunately enough, Gemmett was a player which I followed for a long time. I remember him playing under 20s at the Broncos. He meets the prototype of centre which we like, carries strong from the back end of the field, really good defensively, and he's really clear with when he makes his decisions. So trying to do our due diligence and get the right people at our club, and I really believe he's one of them.
While the hard work around Knights HQ is important, giving back to the community is just as crucial.
Aiden is on here, Jacob's on here, Zach.
Today, the squad are at the John Hunter Children's Hospital, spreading some Christmas cheer.
How are we?
Hello.
He's going shy at us. We've got some gifts for you, little man. We need to be Jeff's buddy. He doesn't like footy. How are you? That's for you.
Oh. Oh, what's enough for your car?
Yeah. You're gonna kick it? Go. Just go. Yeah, well. Oh. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
As the sun sets on another day, another begins. In between another long day, the boys use their break to let off a little steam.
I'm going to say this guy's more strong.
I'm just grabbing him down. I'm scared. I got the bow and I say, are these yours?
Just strong.
Walk off. What is it? Are
He's yours too.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yours.
Back at Knights HQ, and Herman Sasa is excited to welcome our new recruit, Gamet Shibasaki, to our club.
I was pretty close with Gamet. He was coming up through the younger grades under 20s, and he's trained with us a few times. I really love it. I think, you know, it's a young team, and it's basically the same age group that we had back at Bronx, and everyone's close with each other, like the same age group and that. So, and I think he knows a few boys here. I think he was pretty close with Inari, grew up with Inari up in Townsville. So he knows Tao and myself and a few other boys. So I think he'll adapt to it really well.
Yeah, cool.
Sweet. Is that meeting sauce?
Yeah, nah, just the hard fella.
Oh, yeah.
What do you
know?
There's 1 week till the Christmas break, and it's a big one.
Just arrived in Tamworth. It's obviously very warm. The bus ride out was, to be honest, a bit of an eye-opener. How dry and barren everything is. Obviously, being a city boy originally and then moving to Newcastle, that's it's a country town for me. But, coming a bit further up and obviously seeing the struggle out all the towns out this way, but especially towards Tamworth and beyond. But that was the first thing on the drive out, just seeing how dry it all is and a bit of an anticipation about what's ahead.
But for Mitch Pearce and his teammates, they have no idea what's in store. Welcome to Tamworth. The squad has bused 3.5 hours to a drought-stricken community with a purpose. This week is all about resilience. So it's fitting that the team is in a community like Tamworth for 6 days of hard work.
A few boys are making up scenarios with each other, and it's all a bit of fun and games. Obviously we've all been involved in army camps before and different footy camps, so mate, who knows what we're going to do. The coaches assured us or said that it's going to be all around footy, but you never know with these things. And at the end of the day, it's all about character building, and the boys are all keen to get into it.
Aside from training at the Farrer Agricultural High School, Adam O'Brien is using the week away as an opportunity to give back to those who need it most.
Big day yesterday. We're off to visit some of the farmers that we had dinner with last night. Obviously, there's some people out here doing it really tough, and I think that it's really important that our boys get to experience what, the daily routine of, some of these people from the community and what they're going through. So, early stuff for the boys, but so far everyone's really enthusiastic and very keen to dig in and help some of these farmers out.
As soon as we got out there, it was hard getting out of bed at 3:30 in the morning, but once we were out there and driving out and open space, watch the sunrise, it was a great experience.
Mm-hmm.
Oh! Right there.
For Kalen Ponga and Tau Tau Moga, rolling up the sleeves on the farm has been an eye-opening experience.
We're out here on the farm, just checking out the land. Yeah, seeing how bad is it out here, but yeah, it's devastating seeing all this, but hopefully it rains soon. Hopefully it'll be good.
Have you got any country music? Get me in the mood, I reckon.
Now, the boys are put to work.
Oh, yeah, oh! Kalen, that's me. How are you? Get up there. I'll just go around, yep.
Yep,
doesn't matter if I get it wrong?
Yep, fingertips like that.
Oh.
Like that.
There's only one towel, my God. Uh-oh. Oh! Yep.
And sort of, and not tight. You right? Put the comb flat on the skin and you're just following the contour of the body.
Ooh.
So I've been trying to cut them for years.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
I'm happy.
You know how they say countrymen have a hard hand? Nah, not me.
With the morning wrapped up, it's time to hit the paddock they're most used to. And it's time to get comfortable with the uncomfortable.
Training 42 degree heat is definitely a challenge. You know, personally, I enjoy it. It sounds a bit ridiculous, but you're here to get fit in the pre-season, and it's the fastest way to get fit is training in the heat, in my opinion. And you know, you don't get many, you don't get let off the hook. It's about getting out there and getting your job done.
Come off the field, I'm just sitting here thinking what has just happened to myself. And plus the heat as well, it was pretty hot out there. And, it was good, mate. It was good to get out there and tick today off.
Recovery plays a vital role in the life of a professional athlete. A key component of recovering is ensuring you are getting the right nutrition.
As footy players, we have a lot of routine, but we get a lot of sleep, and it's very structured when you know you're getting up and all that sort of stuff. So the curveballs of not knowing when you get up is definitely a challenge. And then to top that up with a bash up as soon as you get up at that time of the morning when your body's not feeling its strongest has been challenging, but probably the hardest thing is doing that and then backing up for brekkie and then going again on the field in the 42 degree heat.
There's no water, no feed. I couldn't afford to keep feeding them.
She's a single mum and farmer, and all that Sally has left is her five kids. The simple gesture of a tank of water has given them and this single mum hope for a better day.
This is how I want my kids to grow up, on the land, good values, good morals, and when it gets tough, you don't...
Meet Sally.
Don't back out.
She's a single mother doing it tough, and she's joined the team to share her story. While the boys have seen the drought, Sally and her kids are living through it.
That really sort of hit home a bit, sort of softened up the boys a little bit, especially me. Just seeing what she goes through every day and what challenges she has to go through, and thinking of the challenges I complain about in life and what we have at home, and you know, single parent and just, you know, acreage of land, and praying for the rain to come, and you know, not knowing when they're going to have their next shower. And I think she said something that in a meeting where she was talking about, when times get hard, is it really that hard for us guys? She was saying it to us, and that really, that's what myself and the team have taken away from today.
The boys go to bed with a fresh understanding of what resilience looks like. So when the alarm rang at 4:30 the next morning, there was no complaining, just hard work. This week was bigger than self, bigger than the team. It was about community, understanding, and tucking your chin when the odds are stacked against you. And it's this mentality the team needs to adopt before the season 2020 gets underway.
Obviously, I haven't looked past past the Newcastle Knights. I want to stay here as long as I can, and if I could be a one club man, I'd be happy to do so and give it everything I've got. So if I could lock up a long-term deal here, wouldn't want it any other way.
Meet Bradman. Not only does he have one of the best names in the game, he's a footballer. He lives and breathes it. And while most may find their first full-time pre-season a challenge, Bradman is loving every second.
Boys, mate. Without footy, I don't know where I'd be. I honestly couldn't tell you. Footy is sort of all I've had. Never good at school, didn't like it. And yeah, this 100% live my dream. It's the best job in the world. Get to go in, train. it's mad. I love it. Wouldn't change it for anything. We get flogged. It's tough. The thoughts are there saying, oh, I really want to do this, but nah, for sure, I'm living my dream and I love it.
As Bradman heads home for the day, Mitchell Pearce is using the remainder of his afternoon to unwind.
How's your day?
Yeah, it was good.
What did you do?
Big day.
A bit red.
I'm hungry. Yeah, I try and be pretty routine based. When I got structure in my life, I'm definitely more focused and prepared, so I think we all are. So normally come home, chuck the clothes in the washing, get them sorted into the dryer, pack my bag for the night before, and then, like I said, switch off, spend time with my girlfriend, watch some TV, have a good feed, and then get ready to go again.
Like Bradman, Mitch is a football tragic. Even when at home, the game is never too far from his mind.
This is my man cave in here. Yeah, it's just got a little bit of memorabilia here, and this is the Knights hat that I got given. Well, all the boys that debut get given pretty much the equivalent of the baggy green for the cricket. So really privileged to have obviously got that on my debut at the club, and then just sit up there on the wall. That was my 250th game one. A lot of my footy was played at the Roosters, but nice pink jersey for it. Very manly. But yeah, it's always great getting milestones. You don't play for that, but they're nice to be able to put up here, and when Nan comes up, she gets a kick out of that. Opportunity to play 300 games, it's not something I really look at all the time, but when you know it's around the corner, it's obviously a nice little thing you'd want to tick off. But you know, there's plenty of other goals I got before that. You know, Knights top four sounds a lot better than 300 games.
He understands that, you know, it starts with him, but also, you know, how he is off the field as well. He's, you know, he's really worked hard at I guess some perception, and some of that perception is not warranted. It's unfair perception. So, look, he's a good guy. He's a good guy on and off the field. I enjoy coaching him. You know, we're mates, but he understands the player-coach relationship, and that's a good one. So, yeah, it makes sense. He's our leader.
Before Mitch and his teammates know it, the sun is rising on another tough day.
Two more each set. Nice H, that's good. That's it, nice. Look into the sun, Texie, a bit glary. Good, Tex.
That's you, buddy.
Yours, buddy, as soon as he kicked it.
No.
Go and get ready for what you got next, lads. Done.
As Scott and the team wrap up another training session, a handful of players have flexed their charitable muscles in a bid to raise money for those impacted by the devastating bushfires. When the team heard that Adam O'Brien's hometown of Batemans Bay was one of the heaviest hit over the Christmas break, the troops sprung into action.
Australian 2018 jersey, all signed from the boys.
But mate, yeah, this debut one was a special moment, and more than happy to give it away to the families or however we can help in a small way. I know it's not going to make a massive difference, but hopefully we can help as much as I can.
It's a busy day of a different kind. We're at McDonald Jones Stadium for team photo and headshots. A day like this is something all 16 NRL clubs must do.
Head back in, and you've got four stations in here.
So ready, guys. For the veterans, they've done it plenty of times. But for many of the group, this is a new experience.
Get to making with time. When it hits you, yes, yes, you. When it hits you, yes, yes, when it hits you, yes, yes, you. When it hits you, yes.
Yeah, so we're here at the team photo day. I guess now we're doing media. We've got our team photos done, which is good. Get the boys in the kit. Everyone's got new haircuts all of a sudden, so looking fresh, feeling good. Got a few stations to get around. For the people that like getting photos taken, they're having a ball. So, Connor. Who else? Sione doesn't mind it.
Yeah.
Kurt. Yeah. But yeah, it's a big day.
As a one-team town, giving back to the community is a focus for the team. As a club, no one sits above the town. We are part of it. Active members. Today is dedicated to the supporters. It's a day to rub shoulders and sign a lot of autographs.
See all the fans out here. It's an eye-opener, rainy day, and there's thousands of people here. I guess that's the good thing about Newcastle is all the fans and supporters that always turn up. So.
around Knights HQ, it's dead quiet. It's Wednesday, which is the boys' rostered day off for recovery. As Lachlan Fitzgibbon rises to start his day, a quick snack is on the menu before venturing to Dixon Park Beach for their recovery session.
Cambridge's elevator music, absolutely unreal.
This week, the boys are starting the day off a little differently. Newcastle. Beautiful one day, perfect the next. Not a bad office for the squad to start their day off.
This is our first session off-site. Gives a chance for the boys to, it's actually an add-on to the week where the training intensity has been that high that I think we needed an extra recovery session, and the boys have jumped on it and come in on their day off to get massage and jump in the water. So we've got a few more days to nail the back end of this week. And in line with that, the boys really need to up their preparation and up their recovery to be able to deal with what we're throwing at them at the moment. So it's an exciting time of the year. We're only a certain amount of weeks away from football. Everyone needs to be doing everything they can to stay on the field and get through this intense period. Yeah, the tracker, mate.
Coach and staff told us to come down and get swimming, getting salt on the body, and got some massage too. It's pretty good leading into the big couple of weeks we've got left before trials and nines, and the big couple of weeks we've had too. They've been tough, and I think the boys appreciate the little bit extra recovery at the moment. I'm feeling real good. Fitness I felt, strong as I felt, so I'm looking forward to a big year.
Obviously, there's a lot of new coaching staff and, you know, fresh ideas, and training's ramped up, and it's a different style of training. We're playing a lot of like conditioning games and a lot of football specific games, which I think this year it's about, you know, playing our best footy, but you know, over a consistent period of time. You know, it's the best town in the world, I believe, and you know, I couldn't see myself you know, growing old anywhere else. Yeah, couldn't praise it anymore, so.
A day at the beach is short-lived, with the boys hitting the paddock in the 40-degree heat the following day. But it's not all sweat and heavy breathing. Mitchell Pearce is pulled aside. A supporter has a surprise for him and hit him with a special request.
Look at that. A little goat and everything. Oh, that's unreal. I really appreciate that. Should we just sign it?
Yes, please.
Yeah. Let's see. What do you want me to write on it? What school do you go to?
St. Phillips at Waratah.
Oh, yeah. Do you like school?
Yeah, it's
alright. Punished, isn't it? You look smart, though. You look like a smart kid. Yeah, I'll give you this, mate. See if there's a bit of stuff in there.
Cool.
You have to sneak it from your nan, or are you going to keep it?
I'm keeping it.
Good on you, mate. Nah, thanks, mate. That looks unreal. Mm-hmm. That's unreal.
It's promo day. 9 of our players and the coach are off to Sydney for a shoot with Fox League. 4 hours of smiling, posing, and sharing a few laughs in between.
By to get the Newcastle Knights here in the fan hot seat, all the different workstations here at Fox League. But for the fan, I have found the players are fantastic. Can't wait to interview the likes of Clem, Mitchell Pearce, Kalen, Connor Watson, Mitch Barnett. But I can't tell you what we're going to do.
Used to run around in the field and tackling and lifting weights and all that sort of stuff, but
It's something different. You get in and you see sort of how everything's made it, you know, behind the scenes. So, you know, you see all these cool shots they have before games and that sort of stuff, and then you get to see how they put them together. So that's interesting. And yeah, you just get in and do it and make the most of it.
Connie's a natural at this type of stuff. He'll tell you he doesn't like the camera, but he loves it. The KP over there, he also loves that type of stuff too. Being a prop, like I said before, he's not my cup of tea, but... Ooh, sorry, squeezed through his. Matty John's there. Obviously Newcastle great, but...
When it comes to marketing shoots, it always helps to relax. Or in Connor and Kaelin's case, dance like nobody is watching. Coach Adam O'Brien, the publicity tour is a new experience, and he's taking it all in his strides, with plenty of familiar faces about to keep up the energy.
Yeah. You're down there, bro.
Let's do it, Mitch. I'm just going to fire.
As a legend of our club, Matty Johns relishes the opportunity to talk shop with our captain.
Sweet. How's Joey going?
Joey's good. By Joey's standards, Joey's good.
Yeah, it's good.
Can I fit a training? Yeah, fit a training's alright. Mate, just unbelievable supporters and the support they gave. You know, my family over the years has been fantastic. 2020, I'm absolutely certain it's going to be an exciting year.
Good. How'd you go?
Good, mate.
What'd you have to do? What have you been doing?
I love watching Connor Watson, big Lockie Fitzgibbon. He gets into it a bit, so that's not my go. I just look at them and laugh, so they enjoy it. It's different, but it's part of the game, and for us to grow the game and get people to watch it as well, so it's pretty cool.
With the sun set and the curtain drawn on a long day, the boys head for the bus to the hotel for some well-earned R&R.
That's a wrap.
Well, that's a wrap for the Newcastle Knights. It's good they've all gone. They've gone back to the hotel and the bus. That's just me, just standing here.
With the Nines competition edging closer, the jersey design has been completed by talented local artist Mitch Revs.
The artwork originally came about, it was a piece that I created for Surface back in 2018. And it was basically just to capture Newcastle, what Novocastrians are about, to highlight our beautiful coastline, and I guess it's an event that has captured Newcastle businesses and the people that live here. Being a Knights fan my whole life, as well as all my mates, it was kind of a pretty special moment for me to tell them that. But I don't think it'll feel real until I hold the jersey and see the boys kind of wearing that and see it on the television. So it is very exciting.
Connor Watson is the ultimate competitor.
Where you at? Okay, I'm coming now. Finished training today. It's a Tuesday, so it's defense-focused day.
A utility prototype who is versatile and vigilant.
I think the biggest thing for me, sort of coming from a teammate, is trust. Trust is probably the biggest thing. Trust that they're going to be there. Trust that, you know, if someone makes a mistake or a tackle, that they're going to turn up and help them solve the problem.
There's no wasted moments at training. And this week, the boys have clearly picked up the pace.
When the boys step on the field, you know, they bring with them every moment they've exhausted. The hours of sacrifice, the sleepless nights. On this field, there's no ifs, buts or maybes. There's only certainty that everything that was brought was left on the grass. As pre-season winds down, you know, the battered turf, the scars that the boys have collected over the past 14 or so weeks, the bruised bodies that hit the deck over and over again. We do it for each other, for our coaches and families and the supporters, to win and make them proud. There's no other reason.
I'm pleased. If you ask me the first week, you know, would we get the amount of work that we've got done and built the connections with the new staff, I'd be really happy I would have taken that the first week. So I'm pleasantly, not surprised, I'm just content. I think I'm really proud of the guys. You know, they've put in a lot of hard work, and you know, we're in a good spot. We've still got some work to do. We haven't played a game, so let's be brutally honest. So, but yeah, I'm, if you said this is where you're gonna get to, I'd be happy.
It's been a mammoth 3.5 month block. The mental has been just as challenging as the physical. No thrills or flashy toys. Just good old-fashioned roll up the sleeves, hard work. The Newcastle way. With the most taxing work behind them and the trials nipping at their heels, the Nines are just around the corner, and an old boy is gearing up to make a surprise return. Kurt Gidley embodies what it means to be the player.
Tomo, how you going, mate? Great to see you again.
You too.
Look, the town was built, it's a blue collar city, you know. I grew up in Newcastle. I respected the town. It was a blue collar town, blue collar industry, and the expectations around that is to roll up your sleeves and work hard for each other and get down and get dirty. You know, possibly put your head somewhere where it's going to get hurt at different times. And I think that's what the original players in 88 were prepared to do, and they played tough and they made it a real challenge for the opponents that come up the freeway to try and beat the Knights at their home ground. And we certainly need to get back to a fortress that we built in the early days, and look, it's up to these boys to build that resilience and build that toughness throughout 2020. Surely I'll get I wasn't expecting this.
He is Newcastle, born, bred, and bleeds red and blue.
Hey, Will. How you going, mate? You good? Yeah, good, mate. Good. Coach.
How you going?
Hello, mate. Hello, mate. How you going, mate? You good? Yeah, good, mate.
Hey, boys, he's on a tape. He only needs one session. He's ready to go.
How you going, boys?
He'll be here on Saturday.
Yeah, I'll be here Saturday. Looking forward to it. But, you know, I very much appreciate the invitation to come back involved in the club and pull the jersey back on again. I'm very proud. Obviously, Nova Kashrian to start with, but, you know, for the invitation from Adam and for you boys to accept me into the team, I'm stoked and I'm looking forward to training Saturday, to be honest, to start with. May need to practice a bit of tackle technique, but looking forward to it, boys. I'm I'm very grateful for the opportunity, so thanks. Thanks, mate.
Thanks for doing it, mate.
Thanks, boys. I'll see you Saturday. See ya.
It's not just the players who get a kick out of seeing the former skipper. Some of our most passionate supporters are ecstatic to see the man we know as Gids.
Newcastle Knights, baby. Yeah.
Hey, guys.
This fits like a glove.
While Gidley gears up for a cameo appearance in Perth, 23-year-old Matt Sopalala signs his contract as he pushes his case for an NRL deal. As the winger chases his first NRL contract, a 15-year-old is making history by signing a contract of her own.
In front of the most famous Newcastle team from the past sits the future.
Meet Jessie Southwell. This talented local has become the first female to sign a deal with the club.
Jessie is the younger sister of Gillaroo and multi-code star Hannah Southwell.
Well, Hannah Southwell, take a bow. That was fantastic defence.
A sign of things to come. There's no doubt Jessie will face plenty of challenges as she kicks off her career. And Coach O'Brien has been no different.
It's a big challenge. It's my first time doing this, so that's a challenge in itself. But there's a whole new coaching staff here and a whole new program that we're running through. Obviously Baylen was here last year, but we've implemented a new training regime, so that was a challenge to get that to work, to get the players to buy into it, to get the staff to buy into it, and then also get the staff to connect with this group of players. It's a challenge, but it's one that I felt that we've met.
Hymel Hunt started the pre-season by inking a new two-year deal.
Let's go.
He did so with excitement, and that excitement has now turned into belief.
Yeah, the start of pre-season is very intense. Obviously, some new faces here, young Gam, some of the new boys, Tyrone and Jaden Brayley, but they've brought a great energy to the team, and it's a great competitive nature from all the boys, and it's bringing the best out of us.
The players set the tone for Coach O'Brien and his team prior to training officially getting underway.
The initial surprise was coming into Mayfield and seeing the guys already training. That was a pleasant surprise. It showed me straight away, we're going to start on the right foot, we're going to work hard. Also shows me that what they went through last year had an effect on. So that was a pleasant surprise. That would be the biggest surprise, I think, for that. And probably not a surprise, but something that stood out to me was just how down to earth everyone is, the players, the community, I've really enjoyed that part of it.
And things have only built from there.
I'm really proud of the players', attitude towards community.
The Knights putting their muscle and star power to good use.
Mitch Barnett walked in the door, with the Fires from up north, from the region that Mitch is from, and wanted to help, wanted to make a difference, and it quickly became Mitch to the whole team jumped on board. So what was going to be a ute load of items ended up being a semi-trailer. So straight away that tells me that they're good-hearted blokes. They want to get in and help. You want to go and help in your community, usually that's a sign that you'll help each other in the game. So, and then of course Tamworth, I was really proud of the week at Tamworth, both staff and players. It took a lot of planning, but we got a lot of physical work done out there, but the work that we've done with the community and I've got to thank the community up there. They embraced us, but they also taught us a few things, a few lessons about hardship and resilience. I'm really proud of that. Proud of the players first and foremost, but these people up here, they're willing to dig in together and help each other. So regardless of status or who you are, you're a person and they want to look after you. And I love that about the community, and I think that that's why they do stand on that hill when we're going through tough times. They don't run away from tough times up here, they lean into it. So I really enjoy that part of the community, and I feel like that suits us and we suit them.
Community was what set things apart, which is a reflection of the town and its attitude towards the club. To be the player everyone wants to play with, it takes sacrifice. You need to be selfless. You are driven, team-minded, and competitively spirited. You are resilient. You are a member of the community. You are a Newcastle Knight.